Happy Saturday, guys. This is John Haas at Ramona Music Center. We're going to go through and do a quick review on this beautiful Yamaha guitar and let you know what we think of the build quality and all the parts. And let's get into it. Okay, so this new guitar is absolutely beautiful. Customer brought it in for a setup because the nut down here was really high from the factory. So I would definitely drop that down. Neck didn't need much of an adjustment. And the saddle was pretty close, or the bridge was pretty close to where it needed to be. But I just wanted to talk about some of the features that I think are really cool. I love this tailpiece. It's iconic, you know, being able to have some of the feel of a Bigsby or a big jazz tailpiece, but having it be hard mounted to the top, very interesting Allen wrench screws, you know, that's a pretty innovative idea. I haven't really spent too much time with those claws on the tailpiece, but they're pretty standard for other styles. I really like the finish that they've done to all of this. If you get really close, you can see that I think it's like a satin brushed aluminum, but it's not brushed. It's just satin aluminum look. But it's really consistent on all of the different pieces. It's one of my biggest complaints on guitars is when they get plastic or parts from different factories and they just don't match exactly. They're slightly different colors or different sheens. So really nice finish on these. Also, the fretwork is kind of a cut above what I'm used to seeing for overseas stuff. The really nice attention to detail on these. I mean, they're like mirror finish from the factory, which I hardly see on guitars that are under $1,000. Nice binding. I love this finish too. This is kind of like one of the first steps that you do with like a Paul Reed Smith. They dye the top black and then they sand the black off so that the flame really pops. But I think they just stopped at that stage, which is kind of cool on this one. 5 stars on the shape. You know, it's pretty unique. Let's see the neck. Nice gloss neck. Matching satin aluminum tuners. And the kind of an interesting shape on the neck or the heel where it meets, but I don't see any problems with that. Nice carve away. I always look at the small little finish spots in between, like where the binding dives into the neck, just to see. A lot of times cheaper places will fill that with something because they didn't do a very good job on the binding, but this all looks good. Really interesting attention to detail here on the strap button. A lot of people will just drill into that edge, but they've actually flattened the edge so you get a better surface and a better mounting on the strap button. So high five on that. That's such a stupid little detail that matters a lot to someone who looks at guitars and works on guitars all the time. Nice deep belly cut here, kind of a harder angle than I'm used to seeing on other guitars, but I do like it. There's not much else to talk about the technicals on this, I don't think. Cool guitar. Let's see how it plays. Okay, let's put this thing through its paces. We're gonna play a little bit. This is gonna be on a Redline 20R in their overdrive channel. So a little bit of gain, but not like metal. We're gonna start on the neck pickup. Good response. Tone, really good response, breaks up when you want it to. So I'll switch to the middle pickup. Big drop in gain. Sounds pretty good, but you know, that neck pickup definitely takes it. Bridge pickup. Really nice, crisp. Yeah, fan. It's nice. Couple last minute things too. These volume knobs are real smooth. And I like they have kind of a unique shape and kind of knurl to them. So
Yeah, pretty cool guitar. I'll have to look up the pricing. I'm not sure what it is off the top of my head, but I'm a fan. Pretty sweet.